Hello, my name is Bill and welcome to Mind Your Crypto. Today I have THETA FUEL, TFUEL daily update. Let's see what we will do. Of course, make a price prediction and the technical analysis. If you like the content, please hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell button to turn all the notifications on and share the video. Thank you for watching. If you want, you can join our Telegram group chat. We discuss more and more about the crypto space. Right now, where are we and what we will do from now on? We have gone to 68 cents, guys. We closed a little bit beyond 66 cents. And I told you that if we go there and we can't close and make this as a support level, do not do anything. And if we were down here, guys, and I told you that if we go down from 55 cents, then we are going down all the way to 47, right? It was our next support level. And right now we got the 41 cents to 42 cents. In case we drop down, then you should not do anything. If we drop down from this line, then this is it, guys. We are going further and further down, right? But we will discuss what we will do later on. Right now, I just provide you support levels, starting the Fibonacci retracement from the bottom 19th May, ending up on 9th June 2021 on this top right now. And though we had a Fibonacci extension level, guys, starting from this bottom to this top up to this bottom as well, the reason was we wanted to find major resistance levels and support levels as well. So we want to find, guys, if we can go above the 1.618, which was our previous high, as you can see here, and eventually if we had to go above, then we would stop at 66 cents. We eventually went a little bit above, but we closed at 66 cents, guys, because it was our minus 0.236 Fibonacci retracement level back in the day. If I had to draw my Fibonacci retracement from this bottom up to this top right here, our previous top, right? So we would go here and eventually afterwards we would go down if we couldn't break this. So our next price target is the 80 cents. We will discuss if we can go there. You can see the volume here. It is very, very good, but it is decreasing right now. And the MACD has lost its support level here. Now we're going all the way down. Doesn't look good for the MACD in the 4-hour frame. Very, very scenario. But the price doesn't go so much down, right? So eventually, let's go to see TFUEL against USDT. We are in an oversold situation for the Komodo Channel Index. Therefore, guys, we are here. We might have a swing high again, but we won't be approaching, or we might have a double top, but I don't think we can go easily further above for the next just few days. But after that, we might go there. Let's see the RSI. The RSI is not in an oversold situation. Therefore, we can correct even more. And we lost some support levels. We lost the higher low pattern that we were forming. Now we are about to correct a little bit even more. Even if we are in an oversold situation on the 4-hour frame, I suggest you guys to wait a little bit. Let's see the daily. You can see here, superstar candle, we are going down. We went above the top line of the Bollinger Bands. Very high risk here. We are going now back inside the Bollinger Bands as well. And we want to see whether we will go further down, what we will do. I told you guys back in the days that we had an extremely overbought situation in the daily frame. Same for the Komodo Channel Index. Therefore, now we correct. The angle of the MACD doesn't look good because we are going now a little bit downwards. But what can we do here is something that we did with Matic back in the days, guys. We might find support level in the signal line go upwards. So therefore, a bearish cross might happen, but it isn't bound to happen, right? The angle doesn't look good. However, we might find here a bullish signal if we get rejected and we don't cross the orange line right here. Okay, but in overall, we had a crazy overbought situation. That's why I told you guys here not to invest if you were a short-term new investor, right? So let's go to TFUEL against Bitcoin. We lost the support level, this key support level right here. What we want to maintain is the 0.618. Eventually, if we go down to there, it is fine. But as long as we maintain this, we are fine. If we go even further beyond, we won't. And right now, we have lost a critical support level for me for TFUEL against Bitcoin. and now we are going down on the 4-hour frame. Same here, this is a major support level afterwards in case we go down here. But for now, what we don't want to see is the 4-hour 20-day EMA cross between the 20-day, the yellow line, and the 50-day EMA, the red line. If we see this cross, this bearish cross, this won't be good, guys. For TFUEL against Bitcoin, though, we are still fine on the mid-term, on the daily frame. Even though we are correcting here, guys, we are still fine because I will explain why. When we are having this major distance between the 20-day EMA and the price, we are going to correct, right? The more the distance between the 20-day EMA and the price, the more, usually, the higher the chance we are about to correct, right? So now we are correcting, we want to find our 20-day EMA potential moving average. The cross here might not happen, guys. We hope not to happen, because if this bearish cross happens here, we will be going more downwards, but for now, we still stand good. But we have to be a little bit careful, right? We have to be a little bit careful after this scenario right here. We were in an overbought situation, and that's why I advised you guys back in the days, if we don't close above the 66 to 68 cents, 66 cents, I told you guys, if we don't close above this area and make this a 4-hour frame candle as our support level, then we won't be going upwards. And eventually, we went even beyond 55 cents, and now we went stopping at the 47 cents. You can see how good these are working, right? So in case that we are going down, what you want to do, guys, as long as we are going down, you want to reinvest. But if we lose the 41 cents, guys, remember that this is a very critical support. Losing this will mean we go down even further and even further down, right? So we need to wait and see. A major resistance level afterwards, guys, is the 80 cents. Next price target, in case we are going upwards, in case we find TFUEL going upwards again, is the 80 cents. 80 cents, guys, is the next price target. Have that in your notebook, because we are going there if we break again the 66 cents. But for now, we have to calm down a bit. We have to correct for a bit. Yes, we are in an oversold situation according to the Commodity Channel Index, but this might not be enough in order to go upwards, because we lost the higher low pattern here. You can see we went down losing some support levels. We lost on the MACD some important support levels on the 4-hour frame. And therefore, guys, we are down from this top right here to this bottom 30%, right? We are down a lot. We want to see if we can hold the 47 cents, and especially if we have to fall down the 41 cents, right? So therefore, guys, TFUEL against Bitcoin now is correcting. You can see the daily frame. We had an overbought situation. Therefore, if Bitcoin goes down, then TFUEL will go more and more downwards, right? So for now, if we lose the 47 cents, we are going back to 41 cents. That's for sure. We are going down here. And from here, we will realize if we can go even further above and have a bullish here, this shape where we can go upwards, or we will go downwards from there. If we lose the support, then I believe it is a very critical support to lose. And if we lose that, then I believe we are going further down the 0.5 here line. We are going further and further down. But for now, we have not lost so many things, right? We can still go upwards, but TFUEL is correcting for a bit. I'm not saying we will surely go soon to 80 cents. I'm just saying, guys, that we haven't lost our momentum yet. We might lose it, though, if we see a bearish cross between the 20-day EMA and the 50-day EMA again. And of course, right now, we have some bearish signs on the 4-hour frame, on the RSI and the Commodity Channel Index. You know, I always want to be honest with you guys, and the best thing to do right now is to wait a little bit, because we often see going here and then having a rebound till the 55 cents, then going down again. So I want you to be careful. And of course, guys, don't panic right now. But eventually, if you are a new investor, just wait a little bit till things come down a bit, until things are going to show us if we have a clear buying opportunity or not. Definitely now, losing this support, we are going back here, but we might see something like this going to 41 cents, jumping back to 55 cents. If we see that, that doesn't mean, guys, we are going all the way upwards, right? We need to surpass now the 55 cents again in order to say that we have a chance to go above 68 cents, and therefore we go to 80 cents, which is our next price target. 80 cents, guys, is our next price target. Remember that. But for now, just be, guys, a little bit careful, a little bit cautious, and because I will be the first to tell you, if we are going upwards, then you should invest. This is not a financial advice, guys. Of course, someone can invest here. It's your opinion to decide. I'm just saying that it is too risky here to invest right now, because we are not sure if we are going downwards more, or eventually if we can surpass the swing high. I would like to see stopping here at the 55 cents, never going down, and of course going upwards from here. But we went down from 55 cents, therefore that's why we had to go to the next support level, the 47 cents, right? And next one is the 41 cents, 42 cents. If we go down from here, mark my words, guys, we are going there, and eventually we might have a rebound, but we will see about that. We will talk about that. Right now, the Komodo channel index on the 4-hour frame is in an oversold situation. However, on the daily frame, we have nothing into an oversold situation. The opposite, guys, we are going a little bit downwards. Same here on the Komodo channel index as well. And of course, guys, we need to wait a little bit for now. Thank you so much for watching. Have a fantastic day wherever you are. See you soon with many, many more videos. Bye.